It's a field that excites me personally. What's exciting about this industry is it was still at its infant stage. It was booming, it was growing, and there are many opportunities in this industry. It's a shaping industry, and it plays a role in every individual's life. The pros, of course, are many. Of course, you can, one, achieve your goals, and hence there is satisfaction that is achieved by that. Second is, financial gains. If you achieve your goals, you can really do well financially over there. The cons, as I said, there's a lot of determination, okay, that needs to be put over there. The cons, of course, there is always the chance of failure, but again, in my definition of entrepreneur, failure is not an option. It is, if you are risk averse, then you are not really an entrepreneur. At the time when we started, it was 97, it was yet an infant industry. It wasn't, mobile phones were not yet spread, but we saw the opportunity over there. We saw that this industry will grow and will play a major role in everyone's life. So we said, maybe it was the time to join the wagon, as they say. Joining Axiom, I joined Axiom in late 2004. Before that, I was in the police force. I was in the finance department for nearly a year. And then I joined the financial crimes unit in the police also. I think the experience that I gained from over there is the general administration experience. The type of work I currently do is really unrelated to what I was doing in the past. The current type of work is more to do about the sales and marketing aspects. In my previous role, it was more a managerial role. One, of course, is my brother. He was the founder of the company, who started in 97. The company was really started, I would say, we started out of a garage, as they say. The company only started with like three people. Okay. Alhamdulillah, slowly started expanding. I joined the business later on as full-time. He was, for me, he was my first entrepreneurial experience. Because we are an expanding business, alhamdulillah. So even at that time when I joined the business, there was a lot of planning that we were doing. See, every entrepreneur has an idea. And every entrepreneur, let's say, sees an opportunity and tries to build on it. But for anyone also to engage in such activities, he needs to also study the market and see the market. And this is what we were doing continuously. It's always keeping an eye on the market, and it's always keeping a watch. As I said, for us, the mobile industry, when we first started, was yet an infant industry. There wasn't a lot of mobile penetration in the market, but we saw there, by closely monitoring the market, we saw that there is strong growth happening, okay? We envisioned that one day mobile phones will be in everyone's hands. Every stage has its own challenges and its own pressures. If we talk about the startup phase, the startup usually is a challenging period, because usually when you start up in a field, in many of the cases, there will be players that are out there in the market that have been in the market before you, and hence they are bigger than you in the market. And that by itself is a challenge, because you're competing with bigger companies, larger companies, companies that already have scale in the market, while you're still actually small and trying to prove yourself in the market and try to gain whether your supplier's confidence or your partner's confidence. And that takes a lot of time. Many times. we're also a type of a company that believes in change and believe that we need to evolve. something that you start today, or let's say a strategy that you implement today, or a plan that you implement today might be good for today, but it might not be good 2 years, 3 years down the line. And the most difficult thing sometimes to do is, if things are working out well for you, the most difficult thing is to come back to the team and say, we need to change. Maybe I wasn't sure that we were able to move at the pace that we actually wanted to, but alhamdulillah, things worked out well. I think if I look back at things, I think I would have wanted to move much faster. Okay, I think we moved at a good speed, but if we go back in time, I think we would have moved much faster. I think we were slow in some areas, and that is maybe what maybe I highlighted what I learned maybe about myself. I gained a lot of experience whether how to manage through tough decisions, manage through tough industry challenges, and also gain a lot of experience about trying different things and trying to see them work, and also failing in a lot of things. But then again, I believe you only learn by trying out things. One is the belief that you need to, that you can succeed. Okay, one characteristic which is very important is really having that positive energy, really believing that you can make it, okay? Because it is a risk at the end of the day, and you should be willing to take that risk. If you're not willing to take that risk, then don't start up your business. I think more. Okay, I think because the more, I mean, we started in an infant stage only doing mobile handsets, but again, part of the ambition, the more you grow, and if you have that mindset of you need to continue evolving your business, then many opportunities also come up. I mean, we started with mobile handsets, today we are in a range of other businesses selling. I think future plans, our vision is to continuously innovate, to be the best partner for our suppliers and partners. As I said, this is an industry that is continuously evolving, and we aspire to capture the whole value chain of this market, whether it is from supply. I mean, we're starting our own line. I mean, we already started our own line of mobile handsets, okay? Previously, we were only buyers from suppliers. Now we're making our own handsets. Okay, we have our own service centers, and hopefully, we will start what they call a mobile virtual operator. Hopefully, inshallah, and KSA. So, still continue our goals or vision. Still continue to be the same, which is continuous involvement to be the best partner out there. I think throughout this period, our plans change. Because the industry is continuously evolving, we need to also evolve with it. I will definitely try to move much faster. Attitude or knowledge, I think I would go for attitude. Because in my belief, if you have the right attitude, if you have the right mindset, that is the key to your start. You can have the skill, you can have the knowledge, but if you don't have that right mindset, you will fail. You need to have that right mindset, you need to have that dedication, that yes, I can make it happen, that yes, I have that positive energy. It's all in the mindset, it's all about the attitude. If you have the right attitude, you will gain that knowledge, you will gain that experience, and you will gain that skill. I mean, one is the financial gain, but I think the financial gain is not everything. I think a big part of it comes from the self-satisfaction, and I think that goes a long way. If you believe in something and you're determined and you make it happen, I think the self-satisfaction that you get out of this is really more than enough. If you have dreams, if you have ambitions, chase your dreams. But as I mentioned, have the right mindset, have the right attitude. Keep in mind that you will face obstacles. You will face a lot of obstacles. It's not a walk in the park.